In my testing, I got around 11.5% extra performance just from doing that. Hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to my video. Today we're taking a look at Valheim. We'll take a look at all the different settings, how they compare in terms of FPS and fidelity, and lastly I'll show my own optimized settings that I would personally use. If you have any suggestions for future games you would like for me to analyze, feel free to write them in the comments below, and if you liked the video, please like and consider subscribing for future videos. I've divided the video into chapters or parts to make it easier for you to see the performance of the specific setting you are interested in. You can find that either in the description below or just see it on the timeline on the video. Once the video begins, you'll be able to see the name of the setting, the percentile difference between the different settings, and the average FPS. I have recorded all of my footage in 1440p, upscaled to 5K. This was done to ensure that my PC was used to its fullest, but also to allow me to test the game in multiple resolutions when needed. My own specs is a Ryzen 5800X and a 3090. I'm really excited to test Valheim since this is a very special game, both in terms of gameplay and mechanics, but also in terms of graphics. Like pretty much everyone else, I love this game. It's without a doubt the best early access game I've ever played, and generally one of the better survival games I've played, both in terms of stability and gameplay. However, that does not mean that it's perfect, and since it is an early access game, it still has some optimization problems. And one last note before the video begins is that I have a bonus chip which gave me an extra 10% performance without any negative effect, which I'll showcase towards the end of the video. Before we go into the specific setting, I wanted to showcase the two extremes of all low and all ultra to see both the difference in performance but also in fidelity between the two. That's the footage currently running in the background. There's a few points to take from this. First of all, the game is really ugly and on the borderline of unplayable when you have it set to all low across all the settings. Secondly, as you can probably notice, you cannot completely eliminate pop-ins even when you're running on the highest possible setting. As you can see in the video, there's a 54% difference between all low and all ultra, so we do have a lot of headroom we can work with. So let's get started. The first setting we'll be taking a look at is vegetation quality. Vegetation quality determines both the quality, but also the density of the vegetation inside the game. This is most noticeable with the grass, where you can see while we have it on low, we completely eliminate and remove all of the grass. And once we turn it up between medium and high, the only difference between those two settings is the actual density of the grass. So the range in which the grass will load in is the same on both medium and high. However, once you go up to high, you get a bit more dense, a bit more grass on the ground. Since you completely disable vegetation when you turn it down to low, this is not a setting I would recommend to use. However, I would recommend to use medium because you have a 7% performance difference between medium and high, and the quality difference in the density of the grass is not that noticeable. Next up, we have particle lights. Particle lights determines the amount of graphical particles inside the game. So those particles could either be the sparks coming from fires or the snow falling in the snowy areas of the game. As you can see, there's not much difference in terms of both FPS and fidelity, at least in this example I'm showing right here. However, since this can affect the amount of snow in the game, I would recommend to leave this in high. It's only a couple percent of performance you lose, but it can make a big difference in setting that atmosphere the game is really good at creating. Next up, we have draw distance slash level of detail. This setting is twofold. Firstly, it affects the draw distance. So this means how far away different items will load in. The draw distance is mostly affected between low and medium. Once you go up to high and very high, that's where the level of detail is affected. So an example of that is the trees in the distance. You can see while we are on low, we are missing some of the trees we can see on high or medium or very high. However, between medium and all the way up to very high, we don't get any more of those trees in the background. We already have all of them by the time we hit medium. However, once we go up to a high, you'll see the difference in terms of the rocks in the middle. If you notice that hole in the middle with the rocks around it, you can see that on medium we only have two of those. On high, we suddenly get a lot more, and on very high, we get all of them. So that's where the level of detail comes in. Because of all this, and because the game in general have, even on very high, have a very short draw distance and level of detail, I recommend to leave this at very high. You do lose around 9% performance, but it's definitely worth it because you're already gonna get a lot of pop-ins just from having it on very high. As you can see, it can make a huge difference in terms of the level of detail as well, not just the draw distance. Next up, we have shadow quality. Shadow quality determines the quality of all the different shadows inside the game. So the higher the setting you have, the higher resolution your shadows will have. So once you go down to lower quality levels of shadows, you'll notice that the shadows become a bit more blurry in terms of the different trees and leaves you normally will be able to see in the shadows. In my testing, I tested both firstly in 5K, like I've done with all the other tests, but I also tested this in 1440p because I noticed that I wasn't actually getting any difference between low and high, at least in terms of performance. You can see it's only a couple percent performance at best, which is really low for a shadow setting. Normally shadow settings make a huge impact on the performance of the games. So once I tested in 1440p, as you can see right now, I found a 15% performance difference, which is a lot more. I also tested in 1080p, even though I don't have that on video, and the results were about the same. But no matter what, I would recommend that if you have it if you're sitting in 5K or maybe more realistically 4K, you might as well just use high because it seems to be no difference in performance for you, so there's no reason not to use high. However, if you are in 1440p or 1080p, I would probably recommend medium because there's not that much of a difference in terms of quality between medium and high. However, you do get a lot more FPS from using medium over high. Next up, we have Bloom. Bloom adds some extra realistic lighting to different lighting sources in the game. So that could, for example, be the sun that I'm currently looking at in this clip. As you can see, it looks a lot more realistic while we have it on, and a lot sharper while we have it on. Something you would expect if you were actually looking at the sun in real life. Which, don't do that, that's bad for your eyes. Therefore, I would definitely recommend to leave this on, because it helps create that atmosphere that the game is really good at. And you only lose a couple percent performance anyways. Next up, we have SSAO, or Screen Space Ambient Occlusion. Screen Space Ambient Occlusion simulates the impact of ambient light and shading around the different edges of objects, increasing the realism of the game's shadows. And as you can see, this has a dramatic effect on this game. Usually it does make a huge difference in other games as well, but in this game, I actually think you have to have it on to play the game, because you can see while we have it off, the game is incredibly bright to look at. Like, you have to turn down your brightness of your monitor or something like that to actually play the game without it. Which is a bit too bad because you lose a lot of FPS having it on, but as you can see, the game also looks a lot better with it on, so I would definitely recommend to leaving this on. Next up, we have Sunshaft. Sunshaft creates beams of light around brightly lit sources, so it kind of works together with Bloom to create more realistic bright lighting in the game. And as you can see, this also applies to the sun as well as Bloom did. And again, as with Bloom, I definitely recommend to leaving this on. You do lose around 5-6% performance, but it is one of those settings that helps bring this game and gives it that atmosphere that I really like about it. However, if you don't like it, you can always turn it off and get some extra performance. Next up, we have Motion Blur. Motion Blur adds an extra blurriness to the image while you're moving your camera around. As you can see here in my example, we lose around 7% of our performance while we have it enabled. For most people, it will not make sense to have this enabled, because it's just gonna lose FPS and make the image look a lot less sharp, which can be kinda annoying when you're running around, at least that's my own personal preference. However, I will say that if you're running in the lower FPS, so around 30, maybe a bit above, maybe a bit below, it might actually be worth it bending that some of your performance on enabling motion blur and then capping your FPS to something that you can actually hold, so be that 25 FPS or maybe 30, because motion blur is often used on consoles, because consoles will often run a game at around 30 FPS, at least some of the a bit older consoles. And while you have motion blur enabled, this will make the image look a bit smoother in a way and it will trick your mind into thinking that it's actually running at a higher FPS than it is. So it might be worth checking out. But if you're not in that category, I would definitely recommend to turning this off. Next up, we have Tessellation. Tessellation adds extra geometrical detail to the landscape. So that could be, for an instance, like the example I have in the video, when you have these kinds of hills or different diggings into the ground or something similar like that. However, as you can probably see, there's not much difference between the two. I also tried in several other locations, but I couldn't really find any difference between having it off or having it on. And since you do lose around 2-3% performance, I feel like this is an easy one to turn off. Next up, we have soft particles. Soft particle helps softening up the particles as they disappear. So as the smoke or the different sparks from the fire, as they slowly disappear, they will actually, you know, slowly disappear instead of just poof and they're gone. To make it seem a bit more realistic and a bit more smooth to look at. It's hard to explain, but it's kind of like having a transition between two things, so it will slowly fade off. As you can see, this has no impact on either performance or really any quality impact as well. So I would just recommend to leaving this on, because since it doesn't affect your performance, it might affect quality in a certain other place that I haven't tested. So you might as well just leave it on. Next up, we have depth of field. Depth of field adds a filter on the different things you're looking at in the game. This filter applies a blurriness to everything else beside the very thing you are directly staring at, your character is directly staring at. As you can see on the left, we'll have it disabled, everything is completely clear, I can see everything on my screen. However, on the right, while I have it enabled, anything but the roof right in front of me that I'm currently looking at with my character is kind of blurred out and tougher to look at in general. I would generally recommend anyone to take it off and leave it off, because you do lose around 11 to 12% performance. Next up, we have anti-aliasing. Anti-aliasing removes jagged edges around different objects in the game. This is most noticeable around the leaves on the different trees in the game. However, as you can see from my example, there's not that much difference between both in terms of performance, but also in terms of the actual quality of the game, the way it looks, whether you have it on or off. This is especially noticeable at 5K. If we move down to 2K or 1440p, there's a bit more of a difference between having it off or on, but it's still very subtle in terms of your performance loss. And the same goes for when we go all the way down to 1080p. The difference is definitely there in terms of quality now, but the performance difference is still very narrow. It's only around 3 to 4% or something like that. The reason that anti-aliasing is having such a small effect in both performance but also quality is probably because of the way the game looks. It has a more of a low poly look to it, so anti-aliasing doesn't have the same effect as it would on a game like Modern Warfare, where they're trying to go for a more realistic look. Therefore, I would recommend, no matter what resolution you're playing at, to just leave this on. Next up, we have Chromatic Aberration. Chromatic aberration is one of those settings that's completely personal preference. Chromatic aberration makes it so that it looks like you're looking through the lens of a camera while looking at the game. The best way to show this is if you look up in the top left corner on the trees, in the top left corner of my example here. You can see on the left it looks completely normal, however on the right they look kinda distorted maybe in a way, or stressed out. Which is that lens effect working on the game. Like I said, whether you like it or not is up to yourself, it's personal preference. It is only going to take around 2% performance, so it's very minimal. And if you like the effect, it's definitely worth losing those 2%. Next up, we have Vsync. Normally, Vsync is not something I would test, but in this game, I had to make an exception because I know that several people have reported that they actually get worse FPS and worse frame time as well, enabling Vsync. Therefore, I could not recommend leaving this on. I have tried testing myself. I did not experience any problems personally, but I have seen other video evidence of people experiencing problems. So for now, I would recommend just leaving this off. If you do want to cap your FPS to your monitor's refresh rate, which is basically what Vsync does, there are several other tools you can use for that. And lastly, we have my little bonus tip that I recommend for anyone to use. I can't take credit for the fix, but I can take credit for finding the error as well myself. You see, when I'm testing these games, I'm always upscaling to 5K to make sure that I'm utilizing my PC to its fullest. But that wouldn't work in this game for some reason. And the solution to that is, the problem was that the game is not actually running in full screen, even though you tick that little box that says full screen. It's still not running in exclusive full screen. I think it's running in something like borderless. Solution to that, which I found from Digital Foundry, is that you need to go into Steam, into your library, open the properties up on the game, and then type in under the extra, type in dash window dash mode space and then exclusive, just like it's shown on the screen right here. When you do that, you force the game into exclusive full screen. which then gives you, in my testing, I got around 11.5% extra performance just from doing that. There's no downside to it whatsoever. So this is definitely something I recommend for anyone to do. Here are my own recommended settings. These are the ones that I would personally use and are based off the recommendations I've made throughout the video. Do keep in mind that these settings is based off my own hardware, which is currently a 5800X and a 3090. And your hardware is going to be different, therefore you need to watch the video and select the settings best suited for your system. This time I wanted to showcase running the game both with and without Vulkan on my recommended settings. As you can see, I do get around 4% difference in performance between having Vulkan on and off. Therefore I would recommend to try Vulkan out and see if you can get better FPS as well. However, you do need to keep in mind that Vulkan changes a lot, or the performance changes a lot based on your hardware. So some of you may even get worse performance from having it on. So try it out and see what you get. If we look at my recommended settings in general, you can see that we gain around 29% performance compared to having the game set on all ultra, while having negligible differences in quality between the two. This also puts us in the 60 FPS and above range, which is pretty good. Also remember that throughout my recommendations, I have chosen the higher end of that recommendation, so you could select the lower end and get a bit better performance. Thank you all for watching. If you made it this far and have been able to use this video to get better FPS in Valheim, please like and subscribe for future videos where we'll take a look at other games. If you have any suggestions for those other games I should make a video on, please leave that in the comments below. Or if you have any feedback or anything else relevant, please leave it in the comments below as well. Also, if you have any other tips and tricks I missed on how to get more FPS in Valheim, please share them with the other people in the comments. If you're interested in these kinds of videos, maybe check out the video I made on Ark Survival Evolved or Rust. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.